Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. So far, we have discussed methods of solving systems of two linear equations in two variables, including the substitution method and the elimination method. We also showed how a system of linear equations could be used to find a time and place where two runners, starting at different times in a race, will meet. But what other types of problems can be solved using systems of linear equations? Let's start by looking at a few problems from earlier lectures which we solved without creating systems of equations. One problem from the lecture Solving Problems with Linear Equations involved finding the dimensions of three identical dog pens. In this problem, we have exactly 180 feet of fence, all of which must be used to enclose and separate the pens. And we are told that each pen's length must be twice its width plus 3 feet. We solved this problem by creating a single variable w, which we use to represent the width of a pen. We then created an expression for the total length of fence by adding the four fence segments of length 2w plus 3 plus the six shorter segments of length w, which we knew must total 180 feet. Since this equation has only a single variable w, it can be solved to find the value of w. So, although this problem has two unknowns, the length and width of a pen, we are able to express both unknowns in terms of a single variable, w. We can then combine these expressions to create a single equation. But instead of creating a single equation with one variable, this problem can also be solved by creating a system of two equations in two variables. To do this, we assign two variables, L and W, to represent the length and width of a pen. We can then create two equations, each of which states one relationship between the variables. The first equation states that the four length segments plus the six width segments equals 180 feet. The second equation states that the length of a pen is twice its width plus 3 feet. This gives us a system of two equations in two variables. Solving this system using the elimination method, we first rewrite the second equation so that both equations are in standard form. We can now eliminate either variable L or W by choosing an appropriate multiplier for the second equation before adding the equations. If we choose to eliminate the variable w, we multiply the second equation by 3. Now, when we add the equations, the w terms disappear, giving us the equation 7L equals 189, or, dividing both sides by 7, L equals 27. We can then substitute this value into either of the original equations to find the value for w. Since the bottom equation is the simpler of the two, we will use it to calculate the value of w. Subtracting 27 from both sides, we eliminate that term on the left. And completing the arithmetic, we get negative 2w equals negative 24, or w equals 12. So this problem, containing two unknowns, can be solved by creating a single equation with a single variable, expressing both unknowns in terms of that one variable. Or we can solve the problem by creating a system of two equations in two variables, where each unknown is represented by a different variable. Now let's look at another example from the lecture, Solving Motion Problems with Linear Equations. In this problem, a car and a bus are each traveling at constant speeds in opposite directions on a highway. 3 hours after they pass each other, they are 360 miles apart. If the car is traveling 10 miles per hour faster than the bus, how fast is each vehicle traveling? We solved this problem by creating a single equation with a single variable s, which represented the speed of the bus. We then represented the speed of the car as s plus 10, since the car's speed is 10 miles per hour faster than the bus. We know that both vehicles traveled for 3 hours. So knowing that speed times time equals distance, we wrote expressions for the distance traveled by each vehicle. In 3 hours, the bus traveled 3s miles, and the car traveled 3 times s plus 10 miles. Since the sum of these distances must equal the distance between the two vehicles, or 360 miles, we could then create a single equation which can be solved to find the value of s. Solving this equation, we get s equals 55, which tells us that the bus's speed is 55 miles per hour, and the car's speed is 55 plus 10, or 65 miles per hour. So just as in the previous example, we were able to express both unknowns in terms of a single variable and write expressions for the distances traveled by each vehicle using only that one variable. These expressions were then combined to create a single equation. But once again, this problem can also be solved by creating a system of two equations in two variables. To do this, we assign the variables s and r to represent the speeds of the bus and the car. Since distance is equal to speed times time, the distances traveled for the bus and the car are 3s miles and 3r miles. We can then create two equations, each of which states one relationship between the variables. The first equation states that the distance traveled by the car plus the distance traveled by the bus is equal to 360 miles. The second equation states that the speed of the car is 10 miles per hour faster than the speed of the bus. This gives us a system of two equations in two variables. Solving this system using the elimination method, we first rewrite the second equation so that both equations are in standard form. We can now eliminate either variable s or r by choosing an appropriate multiplier for the second equation before adding the equations. If we choose to eliminate s, we multiply the second equation by 3. Now, when we add the equations, the s terms disappear, giving us the equation 6r equals 390, or dividing both sides by 6, r equals 65. We can then substitute this value into either of the original equations to find the value for s. Since the bottom equation is the simpler of the two, we will use it to calculate the value of s. Subtracting 65 from both sides eliminates this term on the left. And completing the arithmetic, we get negative s equals negative 55, or s equals 55. So this problem containing two unknowns can be solved by creating a single equation with a single variable, expressing both unknowns in terms of that one variable. Or we can solve this problem by creating a system of two equations in two variables, where each unknown is represented by a different variable. The method which is easiest depends upon the problem. The two examples which we have seen so far could be solved using either method with similar difficulty. However, in some cases, creating a system of equations is clearly the easier method. For example, let's solve a problem involving different combinations of items which cost different prices. John, Denny, Michelle, and Cass go to a movie. They spend $69 on 4 movie tickets and 3 drinks. But Roger, David, Chris, Jean, and Michael are also going to see the same movie. And they spend $88 on 5 movie tickets and 4 drinks. So given the information that 4 tickets plus 3 drinks cost $69, and 5 tickets plus 4 drinks cost $88, is it possible to calculate the pricing at the theater for tickets and drinks? Solving this problem by creating a system of equations is straightforward. If we let T represent the price of a ticket, and D represent the price of a drink, we can easily create a system of two equations in two variables, T and D. We can then use the elimination method to eliminate a variable. For instance, if we wish to eliminate the D terms, we multiply the top equation by 4 and the bottom equation by negative 3. Completing the arithmetic, we then add the equations which eliminates the variable D, leaving us with the equation T equals 12. We can then substitute this value into either of the original equations to find the value of D. Since the top equation has the smallest coefficients, we will use it to calculate the value of D. Subtracting 48 from both sides eliminates this term on the left. And completing the arithmetic, we get 3D equals 21, or D equals 7. Since D represents the price of a drink and T represents the price of a ticket, we know that drinks cost $7 each and tickets cost $12 each. So how could we have solved the same problem using a single equation with only one variable? In order to do this, we would have to write one unknown, either the price of tickets or drinks, in terms of the other, so that one of the variables can be eliminated. So let's say we rewrite the first equation so that the price of a ticket is written in terms of the price of a drink. This expression for the price of a ticket could then be substituted into the second equation to eliminate the price of a ticket from that equation. This gives us a single equation with one unknown, the price of a drink, which can be represented with a single variable, D. But all we have done is to eliminate one of the variables through substitution. This was basically no different than solving the system of two equations in two variables using the substitution method. But what if instead of two groups of people who buy tickets and drinks, there are three groups of people who buy tickets, drinks, and popcorn? This problem now has three unknowns: the price of a ticket, the price of a drink, and the price of popcorn, which we could represent by three variables, T, D, and P. This problem would be very difficult to set up using a single equation with one variable. However, the solution can be calculated in a straightforward manner by using a system of three equations in three variables. In the next several lectures, we will introduce methods of solving systems such as these and see how systems of linear equations in three variables can be visualized in three-dimensional space.